Metformin, also known as Glucophage, is known as one of the most effective drugs for weight loss, managing diabetes, and treating PCOS. Over 120 million people are prescribed metformin worldwide. But what a lot of people are not told by their doctor when they're prescribed metformin is about the long list of side effects that affect daily life. And there are other side effects that can be a lot more severe. For example, if you take metformin and you also consume alcohol regularly, you're at risk for one of the scariest side effects, lactic acidosis. Metformin causes lactic acid to build up in the bloodstream. And if your body is not clearing it properly, this can result in coma or death. On top of that, metformin depletes essential nutrients that the body needs, one of which being vitamin B12. If you are taking metformin and you eat a vegan diet, then this is a huge concern. A B12 deficiency can cause memory loss, it can cause nervous system damage, and it can increase your risk of stomach cancer. And if you're an athlete, you definitely want to think twice about taking metformin. Metformin interferes with the primary mechanism in which muscle cells respond to exercise. Studies show that it is more difficult to build muscle when you're taking metformin, and it also impairs exercise performance. Being aware of the side effects of metformin is important. So in today's video, we're going to be going over 13 of the most common side effects so you can make an informed decision on whether or not metformin is right for you. Because, spoiler alert, there are other things you can do that have a similar effect to metformin that don't come with the side effects. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a certified health and nutrition coach. I post videos twice a week here on YouTube talking all things insulin resistance, weight loss, sleep, and more. So if you're ready to take control of your metabolic health, make sure to click that subscribe button. And you can also find me on TikTok and Instagram where I share new posts every single day. In the year 2020, metformin was prescribed over 90 million times in the United States. And while metformin can definitely be effective for managing blood sugar, it does come with a lot of side effects, some mild and some more severe. We're gonna start off by talking about what metformin is and why it works. Then we will get into the side effects and we'll talk about how you can combat them as we go along. Metformin, also known by the brand name Glucophage, is an oral prescription drug that improves how the body responds to insulin. Now, if you've watched some of my other videos, you will probably have heard me say that insulin resistance is the cause of high blood sugar and type 2 diabetes. Insulin is the hormone that shuttles sugar or glucose from our bloodstream to various cells throughout our body. But when we are insulin resistant, our cells stop responding to insulin correctly. They don't take in glucose as they should. Temporarily, the body produces more insulin in order to get the glucose into your cells. So for years, your blood sugar will look normal despite your insulin resistance increasing. There becomes a point though where even the excess insulin can't keep up anymore and your blood sugar will start to rise. And that is when you'll be diagnosed with prediabetes or type 2 diabetes. So where metformin comes in is it helps the cells in your body to accept the glucose more easily. So there isn't as much floating around in your bloodstream. Metformin also reduces the amount of glucose that your liver releases, once again helping to control blood sugar. For women with PCOS, metformin is also very effective because the main symptoms that define PCOS, having an irregular period, high testosterone, and cysts on the ovaries, are all caused by insulin resistance. The vast majority, over 90% of PCOS cases, are caused by insulin resistance. And here's how insulin resistance ties in. Every month, just before ovulation, there should be a big spike in the hormone estrogen. All estrogen is made from testosterone, but high insulin levels block the ovaries from converting it, and the spike in estrogen doesn't happen. So you don't ovulate, the eggs in your ovaries become cysts, and your testosterone is high. And metformin can help to regulate insulin. Metformin helps to improve insulin sensitivity and reduce these main symptoms. Another positive is that metformin can help with weight loss. When you're insulin resistant, it's hard for the body to lose weight. This is because insulin is known as the fat storage hormone. When insulin is high, the body is storing fat. And when insulin is low, the body is burning fat. Basically, when you have high insulin, this signals to your body that there's excess glucose available in your cells, aka excess energy. So they want to use that rather than tapping into your fat stores. So this is why it is so difficult to lose weight if you have PCOS, if you have diabetes, or if you have insulin resistance. And metformin makes it a little bit easier. Now that we understand why metformin is effective, let's get into the side effects. Number one, diarrhea. This is one of the most common side effects of metformin. And this side effect alone is one of the main reasons that people stop taking it. Studies have shown that 75% of people prescribed metformin experience diarrhea. Metformin interferes with the body's ability to absorb, to store, and to metabolize certain nutrients. And this means your body can become depleted in them. Two of these nutrients, vitamin D9 and vitamin B12, can cause digestive distress when they are depleted. Number two, taste disturbances. 10% of people who take metformin say it impairs their taste, specifically that it causes a metallic taste in the mouth. Number three, erectile dysfunction. This is another really common side effect that men who take metformin experience. Metformin causes a significant reduction in testosterone, which can cause erectile dysfunction and a low sex drive. Number five, bloating. Bloating is another common side effect that's caused by metformin interfering with the body's ability to absorb certain nutrients. 25% of people who take metformin experience bloating. Now, some of the side effects relating to digestion that come from metformin do go away after a couple of weeks. This happens for some people, but not for everyone. Some people can experience digestive distress long-term. However, reducing your dose of metformin or making sure that you take it with a meal can help to alleviate this symptom. Number six, nausea and vomiting. 25% of people who take metformin experience nausea when they first start. However, this does also seem to go away for a lot of people when they take it with a meal or after they've been taking it regularly for a couple of weeks. Number seven, fatigue. Feeling tired and weak is another common side effect of metformin. Metformin depletes key nutrients that are needed to ensure that red blood cells of the right size are created in the body so that cells are able to produce energy. Vitamin B9, vitamin B12, and CoQ10 being the main ones here. When you become depleted in these nutrients, you're going to feel weak and tired. Number eight, hair loss. This also ties in with the depletion of vitamin B9. Being low in this nutrient can cause you to lose hair and even develop bald spots. Number nine, muscle pain. As we already discussed, metformin depletes CoQ10, and CoQ10 is needed for muscle energy. People on metformin often complain about random pains in their calves and other muscles throughout the body. Number 10, brain fog. Now, if you haven't caught on already, a lot of the nutrient deficiencies that metformin causes lead to a lot of the side effects. And this includes a depletion in vitamin B12, leading to brain fog. When your vitamin B12 is low, you can also experience memory loss and even mood swings and anger. Number 11, constipation. Now, we spoke earlier in the video about diarrhea being one of the most common side effects of metformin, but for some people, it actually goes the opposite way and it causes constipation. Making sure that you're properly hydrated and that you are getting enough electrolytes can help to alleviate this symptom. And I'll link to one of my favorite electrolyte supplements in the description box down below. Number 12, headaches. 6% of people who take metformin experience regular headaches. These sometimes go away with time, but other times they're caused by the nutrients metformin is depleting. Number 13, indigestion. Again, this occurs because metformin interferes with the body's ability to absorb and metabolize certain nutrients. Because they aren't being metabolized correctly, this can lead to indigestion. And those are 13 of the most common side effects of metformin, aka Glucophage. Now, I mentioned at the start of this video that there are other things you can do that can have a similar effect to metformin. And I say that in the sense that there are things you can do to improve insulin sensitivity. I'm gonna link a video up above that talks about ways to improve insulin sensitivity. These are simple steps you can take, and you can implement one of them or you can implement all of them. Even if you just add one or two, they can make a big difference and have a similar effect to metformin. You don't need to go on a cleanse or an extreme diet to reverse insulin resistance, because I don't know if I've said that yet in this video, but insulin resistance can be reversed. You can reduce your need for metformin or even get off it entirely. And I outlined steps you can take to do this in that video I linked above. Let me know in the comment section down below if you have used metformin, if you're currently taking it, or if you've taken it in the past. Did you experience any of these side effects, and was there anything you did to alleviate them? Let me know down below. I love chatting with you guys and hearing your experiences. If you did enjoy this video, you might also enjoy the video I mentioned on improving insulin sensitivity. You can check it out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my coaching programs, including my 7-day insulin resistance masterclass that has a shopping list, a meal plan, Facebook support, you can check that out here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.